Now we'll study the effect of changing slit width in YDSE. Here you can see this is a typical YDSE setup. And on a slit plane, when a light beam incident which illuminates the two slits, from the two slits cylindrical wavefronts are produced in the forward direction, and the interference effect of which produces a fringe pattern on the screen we already discussed. And this is the slit plane cross section, and I already explained you that the actual slits are rectangular like this. If this is S1 and this is S2, and say the slit length is L and say its width is W. Then if the incident light beam intensity is I, then we can easily find out the total amount of power which is coming out from the beam. From this particular slit, which can be written as slit power. Slit power can be simply written as incident light intensity multiplied by the area of the slit through which the light is coming out. That will be WL. So slit power is IIWL, which is producing a light intensity on a screen. And in this situation, we can write whichever power will be emitted from the slit, the intensity on a screen will be proportional to this power, and as this power is proportional to the width of a screen, we can say that intensity on a screen is proportional to the width of this slit. Here we can write, if a slit produces an intensity I on a screen, then we have, here we can write, I is proportional to the slit power, and a slit power is proportional to slit width, so we can write I is proportional to W, which is the slit width. So if W is the width of individual slits, their intensity which these slits are producing on a screen will be proportional to this W. So here we can write, if both S1 and S2 are of equal width, this implies, we can write on a screen, I1 is equals to I2, where I1, I2 are the intensities produced by these slits individually on a screen. Say if we write it I0, or we can write intensity of bright fringe on a screen will be, if the two equal intensity waves constructively interfere, this will be 4I0. And if we calculate the intensity of dark fringe that is corresponding to destructive interference on a screen, it will be 0, as the two intensities by the slits on a screen are equal. Now, this implies that the interference pattern is sharp. Because if zero intensity fringes are there, we can clearly distinguish bright fringes and dark fringes between them. But say, if slits are of unequal widths, this implies in this equation I1 will not be equals to I2. If this slit is having a width W1, and this having a width W2, such that W1 is greater than W2, then we can directly write the power of a slit 1 will be more than power of a slit 2. So intensity due to slit 1 on a screen will be more than the intensity due to slit 2. So in this situation, if I1 is not equal to I2, we can write intensity of bright fringe on a screen will be root I1 plus root I2 whole square. And intensity of a dark fringe on a screen will be root I1 minus root I2 whole square. So here you can say this is not equal to 0, and there will not be any point on a screen where there will be complete darkness. So on both the fringes, bright and dark, there will be some light intensities, and the two fringes will merge into each other, and we cannot clearly distinguish bright fringes from dark fringes. Or we can say in this situation, interference pattern will not be sharp, it will get blurred due to merging of the two intensities.